name is Soyoung Kang. For those of you who asked, since you already asked me, I'm Korean American. So my name is Korean, and you can practice your Korean on me at any given time if you like K-pop and drama. So I'm here representing NOBI. NOBI is, in case you can't remember, the NOBS. It stands for Grow Knowledge into Being. Because we actually don't believe knowledge should just sit in our heads, but it actually should be applied. And that's where you see real business impact. So we are actually disrupting this whole space of actually the challenge of how do you actually turn knowledge into something that can be applied to help employees be more productive at work. And so with that, I always come bearing gifts because gifts are good. So we have free demo cards. And so the best way to experience NOBI, because we are quite disruptive, is you have to experience it. I will explain and I'll share it in about 10 minutes. But the best way is to download it for free. Renee, she's standing right here in the black, has free taster cards. I also have some. I'm only going to keep it till about 12, so please catch us to try to grab some free taster cards. I'll also leave a stack here so that you can take as many as you want and give them away. So one of the biggest pains actually that are faced in the enterprise space is that current learning and content is actually not really fitting the needs of a modern learner. And so how many of you are tired of getting PowerPoint presentations? Let me tell you a story. So let's say you have a new, this is a real life case example. You are a multi-billion dollar tech company. You have the newest, best product ever. This product is going to disrupt and actually help you increase your revenue because your core profits, quarterly earnings haven't been very good. So now you're so excited to roll this out to 2,000 of your sales employees across, I don't know, 30 countries. What do you do? So today, what you can do is you get your product team together, you put a PowerPoint deck together of this new product, revolutionary, and going to change things, and then you would schedule all these meetings for every different region of how you're going to roll out this product training in 30 different countries to the training guys, and you cross your fingers and you pray and you hope that the sales guys first attend that product training, secondly, read your PowerPoint deck, third, understand it, and if you're really, really lucky, that they might be able to sell that product. Chances are quite low, actually, because the product is brand new, it's disruptive, it's actually complicated. Real-life scenario, it's one of the top 5 software companies. What happened was about 5% of their sales guys actually learned about this revolutionary breakthrough product. Kind of a problem. So if you take that situation, you can send them a PowerPoint deck, but that's not going to actually help them to understand the product to be able to sell them better. You can't attract who actually attended to be able to know if they actually need additional time and kind of a kick in the butt to actually learn that product. I hope you have all the learning people out there. I'm happy to talk to you about the neuroscience of learning, but I won't bore you, the rest of you. It's based on transformative learning theory. It's simply put, you give content, so you need to learn, but after you learn, as adults, we need to reflect. That's where think comes in. There's no right answer. It's not multiple choice. Multiple choice in quizzes, what are they actually testing? It's testing your memory. And we don't need memory anymore because we have Google. So what we need is we need employees who can critically think. So we need to get them to think. After we get them to think, we get them to apply to prove that they've actually understood the principle, and then you get them to share, which increases accountability significantly. As a result of this methodology, we see retention going up more than 40%. We see learning impact sometimes more than 100 to 200% in terms of productivity. Let me give you a short example. I can teach you a new sales technique. So I give you a video to show you the technique. Then I say, based on this amazing video that I just showed you, tell me the two things that you took away from that. Pick. Now I want you to do a short video of yourself doing a sales pitch of that new product, upload a video, share it with the team. Boom. Instant peer-to-peer feedback, social learning, and retention is now applied and I practiced it, and I'm greatly accountable for what I just done. So I'm much more likely to impact it at work. That's a little bit on the product. In terms of the platform itself, Q2 was a busy quarter for us on the product side. We actually have now integrated with over 200 leading productivity apps, including Slack, including HubSpot, so we can link to your CRM system, as well as your employee systems, mail systems, and consumer management systems, etc. And so that's really important so that for the organization, we are part of their automated workflow, and we're not disrupting the way that we actually work. We want to be part of that. In terms of the people, really excited. Our team actually is a really unique team. We all have actually experience in the learning and the teaching and the facilitation space, even my CTO. So we have over 50 years of experience lecturing, facilitating personally thousands of people. So we understood the power of experiential learning face-to-face. And our challenge is, how do we actually use mobile to scale that to millions? It does not exist in the world. I've been looking and cannot find it. So we created it because we couldn't find it. In terms of our global advisory board, this is the first time I'm actually publicly announcing this, so you're the first actually to hear this. We're very excited that the platform has been validated by a global advisory board. The expert on EdTech innovation at Harvard Business School, Professor John Kim, he actually just joined our advisory board. Facebook, she's actually the head of enterprise sales. She was at Google for 11 years. She joined Facebook recently. She's building up the enterprise sales force. We have Dominic Terpak. He is the former president of IMD at Switzerland, which is one of the top executive education providers. We have Udemy, Richard Chu, who is the vice president of business development. He understands the market, he's been around. Of course, we have Yuchen in the back, who I think is going to be talking this afternoon. He's a local HR guru, obviously, here, so he must be an expert. And then we have Ko Woon Hui as well, who's a very well-known angel investor here. So in terms of the team, we're very excited because what we're seeing now is actually market validation and credibility. And why, when I ask them why they joined Yumi to be an advisor, it's because they know it's disruptive and we really are trying to position ourselves as the Facebook for learning and development. And I'm going to take that opportunity.